Hope everyone's doing well. My name is EQ. Welcome to another episode of Stonkaholics. Before we get into it, if you can smash that follow button, smash that like button, smash the subscribe and the share and all the other buttons that are on there, that'd be greatly appreciated. And stop being a bum and join our Discord group. So if you have not been sleeping under a rock, you've seen internet computer, or at least have heard about it and asked yourself, what the fuck is internet computer? Because this thing came out of nowhere, it was created not even a month ago, and we pushed an absurd price all the way up to almost $2,500 on the first day it was released, hitting number 9 on the all-time list at a $17 billion, almost $18 billion market cap. It is an infinite token, so we have no max supply. We have a total supply right now of $469 billion and a circulating supply of 123.9 billion coins. That is verified. And you can see we've been streaming down a little bit. That dip brought us down a nice little chunk, but ICP was one of the few that as this came down, it still recovered real well right after. And it's still been going down, but it looks like it can pump right back up. So before we get all into what ICP is, let's go through some of the stuff that happened with it. People are going crazy talking about this ICP price rally, blah, blah, blah. The biggest thing that went on about it was that one of their major angel investors, known for backing Twitter in the early stage, and the guy from Polychain Capital, who served as a head risk of Coinbase, they were able to get this listed on basically every single exchange at one time, which never happens. That's why we saw this massive peak. I don't know how they pulled it off, but congratulations to those guys. They crushed it. And you're going into later news where banks are already trying to get people to put their money in and give them ICP tokens, talking about how these banks are going to offer bank services for tokens, including spot trading and options trading. So whatever's going on with ICP, they got some shit planned that I don't think any of us really know about. Kind of just hit everyone out of nowhere, and I had to add a little bit just to do it at the bottom, but we'll see what happens. Now going into what internet computer actually is, it's a layer one blockchain. It's going to be the first internet, or basically the first network, that provides a limitless environment for smart contracts that can actually run at web speed, which is basically just instantaneous speed. So you can build everything from DeFi, mass market, social media services, extended Ethereum D apps, kind of like Polygon that we talked about on yesterday's video, and chase the blockchain singularity. So you can see a limitless blockchain, you can build tokenized mass markets, you have nodes, you have a team of almost 200 people working on this project. All of their names are everywhere, so that's a good sign. Got people working all over the world remote. If you want to get some jobs, I'm going to click that too, because it'll be cool to work for this company if they are hiring. So if you're in one of these locations, you can get a job with them. You can see they have a ton of stuff that you can work with. Going into the press, they've been all over the news, Fortune, Wired, Forbes, Wall Street Journal, Tech, Business Insider. And the most important part, essentially what they're doing, is bringing more security to stacks. Stacks are your security basically for all the major companies to protect themselves from DDoS attacks or any sort of virus attack or hackers or anything like that. The blockchains and everything, they work in stacking systems, so they're just very secure stacking programs because none of them are defeatable. The purpose is you're stacking more and more and more and more layers on top just to make it more difficult to hack. It's not saying that it is completely unhackable, it can, but in order for you to do it, you would need a crazy quantum computer and someone that's a rocket scientist of some sort that can figure out how to break these codes and these chains, because they have hackathons and things and try to pay people money. And if you can even break parts of these codes, they end up hiring you on their team as security and paying you out for the rest of your life to work for them and keeping their projects safe. So I don't think this is something that's going to be going away. You can see these IT stacks cost these companies almost $4 trillion annually. And despite these costs, they don't really think about other ways that they can fix it because they just assume that there was no way to fix it. So this is kind of talking about the companies that have been hacked. Multiple companies around the world fall victim to cyber attacks. Current technology does nothing to protect your company against such attacks despite having massive IT security teams. So you can see Marriott, 350 million, and going down this list, all these huge companies that no matter what, even if they're paying this insane amount of money for their stacks, they were still getting hacked and losing all of that customer information. And the worst thing you can do when you're working with customers is lose their trust, which these companies did. Most of them have recovered, as you've seen before, but it's still a real big issue. So systems are insecure by default. You can see companies are spending the majority of their time addressing the complexity of making these these stacks work. So this is where ICP comes in, and they talk about how in 2020 that they're going to remove the need for complexity generating standalone software components such as database servers. Designers and enterprises will no longer need proprietary cloud services, databases, firewall servers, middleware, CDNs, web servers, app servers, any antivirus software. ICP is going to be handling all of that stuff for them. So this is a great project. You can see Stanford University and the guy from the Twitter, that guy that backed Twitter from the beginning, throwing all the names they can on this project. So it's definitely bullish. Now going into the fun part of the charts, we've been watching this little downfall. This pennant played out. Now we pulled out of there. We're getting a support hold in this general area. Let's get down closer to the 4 hour. So looking at the 4 hour, you can see that we are trying to hold a potential SR flip. If you want to bring this a little lower, trying to hold this SR flip right now. We weren't able to hold that level before. Put another layer over here because that's going to be the next SR flip. And the top of this point will be here with a candle being up here. So these are going to be all major potential resistance points for ICP as it moves back up, if it decides to move back up. Now, ideally, we want to see this break up and find a support, hopefully between this 224 and 195 area before we start getting a serious impulse move back up. You can see we've already reached a price of 634. So from current price, even to test the all-time high, you're thinking you're looking at a 350% move, which is a nice little gain. And we really don't know how far this can go on an impulse move because it hasn't technically impulsed yet. The only way you'd really be able to gauge it would be to look at something from here to here. But even then, you're looking at pushing this all the way up to almost 430% based on this little impulse move, which I wouldn't necessarily call an impulse move. But for sakes and purposes, let's just call it that. Now, as it starts to move up, definitely be watching for these other major key levels moving forward that you can see are conveniently enough falling within the pattern. So for example, this 7860 is going to be an area of interest. The 6180 is going to be an area of interest. It'll probably be a major resistance point, considering that there's a resistance here, here, and here already at the 6180. So at $350, which would make sense because it sounds like a major psychological level. It's a rounded out number. Now what we're looking for on some of these other charts, we want to see this break, right? So we've been sitting on the top side of here. Ideally, we want to watch this trend be broken. Once this breaks and start moving forward, we might have to get a hold and come here. We also have to watch out for this 50 RSI resistance. The volume oscillator has been in bearish the whole time, so that's always a good sign. At least it has a lot of room to go up. And the volume on here definitely needs to be picked up a little more. It's not triggering anything of a move incoming anytime soon. So we're going to keep an eye out on ICP moving forward. But this kind of project can definitely stay in the top four projects. Yeah, we're already looking at a $17 or $18 billion market cap, but considering the size, this thing could be a $100 billion market cap project. If it's a $100 billion project, that's a 5x move. If you're at 150 from a 5x move, you're going to be around $750 from a 5x move. And that's kind of similar to where we were sitting before. We got up to around the $640 range. And some wicks on some of the exchanges were going up to around 2,500. So that's basically saying if it wanted to test its all-time high, that's going to be it getting to a $100 billion market cap. So keep that in mind with ICP. And that's going to wrap up this video. If you didn't get a chance before, make sure to like, subscribe to the channel, do all that fun stuff, and we'll catch you on the next one.